बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, आई एम डॉक्टर मोहम्मद मुजम्मिल हसन और आज जो वीडियो आप लोगों के लिए मैं लेकर आया हूँ, दिस इज द मैनुअल रिमूवल ऑफ प्लेसेंटा। तो सबसे पहले तो हम आरएफएम की बात करते हैं कि आप डिक्लेयर कब करते हैं कि एनिमल जो है वो प्लेसेंटा को रोक चुका है। आजकल गर्मी के मौसम में यूजली हम कहते हैं कि 8 से 12 घंटे अगर एनिमल पास्चुरेशन के बाद प्लेसेंटा अगर नहीं फेंकता तो आप इसको कंसिडर करते हैं कि ये आरएफएम का केस है। तो हमारे पास एक जानवर इस वक्त मौजूद है जिसको पास्चुरेशन किए तो 24 घंटे जो है वो हो चुके हैं और इसने अभी तक जो है प्लेसेंटा ड्रॉप नहीं किया। तो सबसे पहले तो मैं आपको ये बता दूं कि हमारे प्रोटोकॉल्स जो पास्चुरेशन के बाद हम लोग अडॉप्ट करते हैं, जैसे ही एनिमल पास्चुरेट होता है वी यूजली इमीडिएटली गो विद द इंजेक्शन ऑफ ऑक्सीटोसिन टू अवॉइड प्रोलैप्स एंड टू एनहेंस द प्रोसीजर फॉर प्लेसेंटल एक्सपल्शन। इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेज, लाइक इन 95% ऑफ द केसेज, with the proper management in the transition period we have about 5% cases of the RFM. So this is one of the cases, and usually there are many factors responsible as well, like in heat, summer, in hot and humid conditions lot of problems are there like RFM. So in this particular case we have injected the animal about 3 times the injections of this oxytocin, 100 international units per ml through IM route, but still she is with RFM. So there are 2 types of the placental this RFM. Number one is the primary RFM and number two is the secondary RFM. So primary RFM, that is the removal of the placenta, that is the union of the cotyledons and the caruncles has taken place, but the uterus has no enough contractions to put it out. This is the case of secondary RFM. What is primary RFM? In case of primary RFM, these unions, they are not broken. So I repeat, in primary RFM, the unions are not broken and we need to separate it manually. And in case of secondary RFM, the unions are broken but the contractions of the uterus are not there to push it out. So we need to see it through the vaginal examination. I will take my hand inside and I will check whether it's a primary RFM or the secondary RFM. Number two, well, how to remove the placenta? I have shared a video to remove the cotyledons from the caruncles on my channel with the name of separation of this cotyledon from the caruncles. I have given the link on the description as well. You can go there and you can check how you can remove these unions. लेकिन एक बार बताता चलूं कि वो क्योंकि prolapse का केस था, उसमें ये सारा procedure जो है animal के मैंने बाहर दो हाथों से किया है, ये काम जो है यहाँ पे मैंने एक हाथ से करना है। So what is the procedure? You can see the hanging part of the placenta. It is hanging outside. I will wear the sleeves on both of my arms. And then I will hold this protruded mass of the placental membrane with the other hand and I will take my left hand inside after proper lubrication. Then I will take my hand between the endometrium and the placenta and I will try to break the unions of the cotyledons and the caruncles with the help of my fingers and thumb, and I will remove that placenta with a little traction. But remember one thing, we do not need to put a lot of pressure. It can lead to mechanical injuries and a lot of other problems can take place. So after removing this placenta, I will tell you what sort of treatment we have to provide to this much animal. Let's
come. So the important thing is that when you are going to remove the placenta, you are going to take your hand inside and you have to lubricate your hands, and with the other hand you are applying a little bit traction. So you can see in this particular case in the right hand the hanging part of the placenta is there and we are applying traction, while with the left hand I'm trying to remove that part which is inside. So how do we know that the placenta has been completely removed? So the buttle like structures, the caruncles are inside. Usually when the placenta is attached it is smooth. So when the part of the placenta is removed, that is the cotyledon part of the this fetal membrane is removed, then the caruncles, the surface of the caruncle, it becomes rough. So it gives you an idea that the placenta has been removed from that part of the caruncle. So usually there are 90 to 120 these caruncles you need to separate, but in this particular case all the caruncles are not that much tightly attached, so a little bit traction was enough to remove that that part of the placenta you can see in this particular case.
Come here. This was a case of a primary RFM because the unions were not separated, right? But luckily, the unions were not that much tight. So I don't need to put a lot of pressure to remove those linkages. So why? The reason being, I was continuously providing this animal 100 international units of oxytocin after every 8 hours. So it enhances. It actually facilitates the separation. If you are giving oxytocin, so you need to put a little effort if after 24 hours, if you are going to remove the placenta, and if you are not given the oxytocin, then you need to put a bit pressure. Number one, important thing, always add this thing in your protocol. You need to give oxytocin so that you may not to put a lot of pressure while removing this placental membranes out. Okay, now the next thing is to do that you need to actually calculate the mass, the size of the placenta. The weight is about 5 to 6 kg. So usually when the animal normally expresses placenta, the size of the weight is about 5 to 6 kg. Number one. Number two, you need to observe the placenta if there are any hemorrhages or necrosis tissue. That is very important in the diagnosis of various reproductive disorders. Now I can show you, Darsap, if you please come here. This portion, this very portion, this is the cotyledons. And these are the villi of the cotyledon. You can see these are the villi. They were attached in the maternal caruncles, right? So there are about 90 to 120 when you talk about these number of caruncles in the maternal uterus. Okay, now the next thing is I am going to provide this animal the treatment, we can say the antibiotic therapy, so that I know that I have just gone inside the uterus. I cannot mitigate, I need to mitigate the infection. I cannot stop that. So for that I am going to provide this animal the medicine, and I will also share the which treatment you need to provide the next 4 to 5 days. Come here. A normal saline. You need to cut it down. So hold it. I need to take about 500 ml of the normal saline. So this is around about 500 ml normal saline. And this is oxytetracycline. The composition, this is basically oxytetracycline PVP. It is less irritant to the endometrium. So, this product contains about 100 milligram of the oxytetracycline per ml. So, the target in this particular case is to put about 6 to 8 gram of the oxytetracycline inside the uterus. So for that purpose I will add this about 80 gram of the oxytetracycline. Now I am going to put this product inside the uterus to mitigate the infection. This is an AI rod and this is a connector. Usually you can use Foley's catheter or you can use the last part, the rubber part of the IV set. Come. 500 ml of the normal saline containing 8 gram of this oxytetracycline inside the uterus. The intrauterine pessaries are also available. You can keep those pessaries as well, like you can keep oxytetracycline pessaries directly inside the uterus. The pessaries are available. You can also use this tetroximin containing the rifaximin salt of the miscellaneous and group of antibiotics directly inside. Okay, now I need to tell you what are the post-manual removal treatments you need to perform. Number one, I need to provide this animal continuous shots of antibiotics for 5 days. I need to provide this animal continuously 5 days of shot of antibiotics. In my experience, amoxicillin with clavulanic acid is very good combination with very excellent results. You can also use the third generation cephalosporin, but you can also use this oxytetracycline. But I do not recommend oxytetracycline. Reason being, unfortunately, if you have this animal with a milk fever in the next 2-3 days, then it will be a problem for you to inject this animal IV calcium. So I avoid the use of this oxytetracycline through the next 4-5 days. So this amoxicillin with clavulanic acid, or you can also use in combination amoxicillin clavulanic acid with the cephalosporins. And lastly, metronidazole is quite important, because this is very important for the this anaerobic bacteria. Remember one thing: if your animals are not vaccinated against Clostridia, so this is the best time where Clostridia can grow if there is some injury inside, and that leads to anaerobic condition inside the uterus, and then it can lead to the problem. Okay, the next treatment is as per sign and symptoms. Like if there is fever, I would go with the antipyretics. If the dry matter intake is less, I need to provide this animal some fluidotropy, and I need to provide the diuretics because the toxins may produce. Okay, next, I need to supplement this animal with the glucose precursors like propylene glycol. You can use glycerol to avoid a long period of ketosis. So hopefully this animal after 20 to 21 days, when I will see that the uterus has involuted, then for 4-5 days, I will keep the solution of oxytetracycline inside the uterus for consecutive 5 days. For that, I need to take 30 ml of the normoxicillin and 30 ml of this Navacin containing 100 mg oxytetracycline per ml. I need to keep this consecutively inside the uterus for 5 days, and you will see animal will be perfectly alright, and the calving interval will be around about 12 to 13 months, inshallah. Hope you, if you have any question, you can write in the comment section. I hope you have liked the video. Thank you very much.